Welcome back guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you guys how to create a vintage logo design very easily with the latest tool from Heritage Type. Kittl editor is a modern online tool which is easy to use, and with its simple UI which gives you everything you need to create a vintage design. Best of all, it's free to use and you don't have to purchase expensive fonts or templates. You can directly use the tool with thousands of freely available designs and assets which are done by other professional designers. It also comes with free layouts, illustrations, effects and font library. To use this tool, you don't need to have any design experience or spend time learning about available tools. With this simple interface, you can quickly understand all tools very easily and drag and drop assets and effects to create your design. I will show you how I created this logo design for a t-shirt print directly in Kittl editor using just readily available illustrations and fonts. Follow the link in the description to sign up for free and get free 3 months premium membership. You don't have to provide any credit card details to sign up. Alright guys, so once you sign up and log into your dashboard, you will see all designs done by other designers. You can directly select these designs and in here you can save it to your library, or you can directly use this as your base design and modify the design the way you want. Or you can also start your own design from scratch. In this case, I'm going to create my new design from scratch. So I can go to these tools in here, go to my projects and create a new project, which will create a blank project in here. And the earlier project will be saved into your library. Alright, so in here, in the settings, you can go in and change the size. As you guys can see, we can find all different sizes for different purposes in here. For this, I'm going to select the postcard size with landscape orientation. Okay, let's create a custom background. You can directly change the background color in here. But for now, let's create a background with basic shapes. To get to the basic shape, you can go to elements in here, in these tools. In here, you can see we have categorized elements. You can go to the basic shapes and show all elements. In here, you can find all available basic shapes. For the background, I'm just going to select this rectangle. You just need to select this, which will automatically apply the elements into your artboard. Now we can align this with these align tools and then expand this to close the entire background. Okay, now we can change the color for this shape. Select the shape and go in here. In the object settings, we can change the color. You also have more settings in here, such as the opacity. But for now, we don't need to worry about it. Before we continue with the design, let's apply a texture. You can go to the texture in here and you can expand to see all available textures. We have many textures in here. They also categorize nicely. For this, I'm going to select one of these textures from here. Once you apply, you can close this, and in here, you can adjust the opacity as well as the blending modes. You can change the blending modes and see which will be nicer with your design. In this case, I'm going to select the soft light and keep the opacity to 75. Okay, so let's start designing our logo design. As you guys saw, for this design, I need to have a vintage look as well as an outdoor feeling based on the theme. So let's go to these elements first in here. Let's get the batch shape for the logo design. In here, we can expand and see all available batch shapes. And for this design, I'm going to select this as my base shape. Once you select, you can close this elements box and use this outer bounding box to rescale your batch. For any elements, when you select, you can see on your right in the object settings, it will appear with all colors which are applied to that shape. So in here, you can go in and change and modify the colors the way you want. By default, when you apply a texture, it will come on top. If you go to the layers in here, you can see the texture layer is on top. To bring it underneath the design, you can do that very easily. Select the texture. First, you have to release the texture from the background settings. Now, you can select the texture layer and bring it underneath the design elements. So if you guys are familiar with Photoshop or Illustrator, in here also, layers work the same way. You can arrange objects front or back based on the layer order. Okay, let's change the color for these elements. As I said, once you select, all colors in this shape will be available to change in these object settings. I'm going to change these colors to something closer to earthly colors. Whatever colors you have applied can be seen underneath the color picker as document palette. Okay, the batch look nice. Now let's add in one more element to the logo. I will go to the elements in here. Go to the search bar. I'm going to search for camping. And in here, you can see all elements related to camping will appear in here. So you can select any of these designs for your artwork. I'm going to select this one in here. Once you select, you can see it will automatically place into your artboard. And you can align them easily with the smart guides. And again, you can select this and change colors with the object settings. Alright, cool. So let's add in more elements to our artwork. This time I'm going to add some trees. So we can go to elements and in here we can search for trees. I'm going to add a couple of different trees from the list. And then let's arrange them nicely behind the tent. Then we can change the colors based on our design. We can bring the tent forward by right click, or we can also move this layer to the front, which will bring it to forward. Okay, now I want to create some depth with the trees. So I will add in some more trees, this time a different type of trees from here, and let's place them in here. We can apply the brown color as in the background. And then copy by alt and drag. So I will use this tree and alt and drag and place in here. Now we can select the 10 hours and bring it forward, bring it to the front. All right, now we can individually select these elements and align them and arrange them nicely with proper 3D depth. Okay, next, let's add in a moon. I want to show this one like a nighttime scene. So I'm going to search for moon and going to select the shape in here. And arrange and place it in here, bring it behind and change the colors. All right, let's add in some birds into the scene. I'm going to apply like 3 birds in here. And then we just need to arrange them nicely. So I will just place them in here like this. All right, for finally inside the batch, let's add in one more element. In here, I'm going to search for river and I want to add in some textures like river underneath the tent. So we can select this shape in here and place it in here and change the colors. I'm going to apply the darker tone for this one in here. All right, so let's go back to the basic shapes in here in the elements. And in the basic shape, I'm going to add this shape into the batch. I'm going to place this underneath the batch like this. All right, next we can scale and change the colors. Okay, so the main portion is almost done. Next, let's add in the text. To add the text, and again, in the same tool section, you can go to the text. In here, you can see all available text with all the effects. There are also text placement available. So in here, you can choose with effects and placement as well. Okay, so for this design, I'm going to select the text from here. I will select this text. Alright, now, like any element, you can just place the text and scale it, and you can double click the text to change the text, and you can use the text settings in here to change the colors for the text and for the shadows based on your design, and you can also use the same settings in here to change the text fun face as well. And in here, with the additional font effect settings, you can control the shadows and effects for the text. And you can add in additional decorations for the font, which will apply classic effects to these fonts. And with these black shadow settings, you can control the depth of the shadow and the angle. I'm going to stick to this design for this font in here. And then let's add the below font. For this again, I will go to the text. In here, let's search for the adventure. We already have a nice font with the adventure. So I'm going to use this template and just place it in here. Now we can use the font orientation settings in here to orientate the font. For example, the first one in here with this, you can move with these anchor points and rotate your font with your shape behind. And like any object, you can select this and go to the text settings in here and change the colors. I will change the colors based on our original design. All right, and then in the elements in illustrations, I'm going to add this shape into our badge. Then I will scale it and place it on top of the adventure logo like this in here and change the color to a darker tone of earthly colors. I will change these birds' colors to the same color as well. And finally, let's add in the year established. For this, you can make this little bit smaller using these magnification settings. And then we can go back to elements in here. And in the banners, let's add in a banner to this shape. Okay, I think this banner suit well. So I'm going to select this and add into our design. Now we can select this and change the colors in this object settings. And finally, we can add in the text on top of this banner. And change the text color and the banner color to fit into the artwork. And you can also select the background object and delete it. And then we can use the background in here in the layers and change the color of the background. This way you can import this file. If you want to import as a PNG, you can import without the background. And again, if you are looking for a texture design, you can go to the textures in here and you can find a lot of different textures. So you can select any of these textures which will apply on top of your complete design. In here, in the settings, you can control the blending modes and opacity of that texture. All right, so we are almost done with our design. Finally, I will just place these two birds outside the batch as well. So we can print them nicely. It will look like a nature scenery. And also, it can be our logo for the t-shirt design as well. All right, guys. Okay, so now the design is done. Once you're done with your design, you can go to the download settings in here and choose to download PNG or JPG. If you are downloading image file, you can remove the background in here and download only the artwork. If you have the premium version, you can download this in PDF and SVG as vector files. These vector files, you can then bring into your Illustrator or any other design application and make changes if you want to. And after you've done your design, you can share this directly to any of the social media, or in here, you can share this to your public community. Once you publish your artwork, other people can choose to use your artwork as a base design and modify them. All right, guys, that's all about it for today. Hope you guys get a good idea about the cool new Kittl design tool. Find the link for Kittl in the description below. Also, find the link for 3 months free premium membership as well. Thank you for watching. See you guys in the next video.